Cars, probably every MCAT taker's worst nightmare. But in this video, I'll be sharing how you can get a 132 like me with ease with my top strategies. First of all, what is CARS? CARS stands for Critical Analysis and Reasoning Skills, which is a section on the MCAT exam. This is the mandatory admissions exam for almost all medical schools in Canada and the US. Especially if you're considering Canadian schools, a lot of schools consider CARS competitively, and some of them require a pretty high cutoff, and if you don't meet this cutoff, you won't make it to the next step of the admission cycle. And because it holds such a high significance in the admissions process and the fact that it relies on reading comprehension and reasoning skills as well as logic skills instead of hard science knowledge, it is a challenging section for many test takers. As I mentioned in my MCAT advice video, the only resources I used were AMC's official prep bundle, Jack Weston's free passages and problems, as well as some of UWorld's CARS questions. So I started off with using Jack Weston's problems because they are free and also because they are relatively more easy than AAMC questions. I will say one thing though, is that if you're using third-party practice, the AAMC is really the gold standard for CARS. If you're using other websites for example, physics, that might be fine. But for CARS, it's very hard to match the same level of difficulty as the AAMC material. So really do all of the CARS questions if you get the AAMC bundle, because that is really what you should be focusing on in your last month or two of practice. The CARS section is made of three types of questions. There's the foundations of comprehension, which is 30%, and this is essentially asking you if a detail was mentioned in the text. There are also the reasoning within the text questions. These questions ask you to use critical analysis skills to analyze sections and arguments within the text, as well as consider the author's perspective and their intentions. Finally, there are the reasoning beyond the text questions, which is 40% of the questions, and they essentially ask you to use analytical skills to extrapolate the paragraph's ideas or the passage's ideas to new contexts. For example, it might ask you to pick an analogy within one of the options that best fits the meaning of the passage. So now I'll get into my top 5 strategies for acing the CARS section. First of all, I just want to give an overview of how I like to approach the CARS section. The CARS section is in total 90 minutes long, and you have 53 questions on it. So you can spend around 1 minute on each question, because you also need to take into account the time that you want to spend reading the passage. And this gives you about 10 minutes per passage. It is enough time if you do get your practice in. So how I like to do it is, first of all, I read the passage for around 3 minutes. If it's a more difficult one, I might take 3.5 minutes. And then I start doing the questions and I spend around 1 minute on each question. In total for each passage, I try to keep it at 8 to 9 minutes. If you reach the 10-minute mark and you still haven't moved on, I recommend you to please move on to the next question. On the exam, it's online, so you can flag it at the top corner and you can choose to come back later. If you really don't know, just click a random answer, flag it and come back later, because on CARS, timing is the most important here. So that goes into my first tip, which is to read the passage first and spend 3 minutes, 3 solid minutes, just reading the passage. Because, as I said, timing is so important, you don't have time to take extensive notes. You can only jot down maybe 1 word per paragraph, and when you come back to read it, it might even waste more time because you are trying to figure out what your cryptic words actually mean. So what I recommend is you read the passage, and there are 2 main things you should be doing when you're reading it. First of all, you need to grasp the main argument and main idea of the passage. Sometimes each paragraph even has its own main argument. That's all you need to know for the first skim through. Next, you also need to keep in mind what is the author's perspective or tone when they're writing this passage. Because a lot of questions later are going to ask you what you think the author might agree or disagree with. So if you already are keeping this in mind while you're reading, this will save you so much time when you're facing those questions. My next tip is to read the question carefully, because sometimes on the MCAT, they might try to trick you with buzzwords or words that seem very similar to some words that were mentioned in the text or have similar meanings but are still different. So you might be tempted to pick that option if you were just skimming the question. So my advice would be to read the question and the options very carefully and try to look for the keyword within the passage itself. Usually, the question or its options will have words that are repeated in the passage, and you just have to locate it in the passage within that particular paragraph and read that paragraph in detail again until you can figure out which is the right answer. Another trick they like to do is that sometimes they would use one word in one of the options, but this word comes from the paragraph before the one they're trying to ask. So make sure that the option that you're choosing was actually mentioned in the passage or can be very undeniably inferred from the passage. This goes into my next tip, which is to not make assumptions and not use outside knowledge. These are sort of similar because you're making assumptions that the author is trying to mean something when they're not actually. So the car section does not require you to have any outside knowledge at all. So if it's asking you about a complex topic and you're freaking out, do not freak out because the answer is within the passage. So this goes into the reasoning type questions that I mentioned. It might ask you which one of the statements would the author most agree with. And in this case, don't try to impose any of your personal opinion into the passage, but instead think about what you would choose if you were the author that wrote this. Another way you can solve this is if the question asks you, for example, which of the following would most weaken the passage's argument? Then you also know that three of these options must be stated or implied within the passage already. So you can use process of elimination if you really can't find the part in the passage that is really inconsistent with the options. Especially for foundations of comprehension questions, do not make any assumptions. This goes into my previous point about buzzwords. They might try to trick you with a similar concepts that the author might have mentioned maybe in a previous paragraph or one that seems similar to the main argument, but you must not let that confuse you or distract you. Usually you can just go through each option, find the keywords and find it in the passage itself and see what that paragraph says. Usually you'll be able to logically reason out the answer from that. My next tip is don't overanalyze or second guess yourself. The MCAT is a game of strategy. Just follow your gut. Don't worry if you mess up one question. You don't need to get 100% to get a 132. Most of the time when I find that I got something wrong, it's because I was overanalyzing and I was overthinking it. Usually, whatever the author's main sentence is for that paragraph is usually what they mean, and don't try to overanalyze it because obviously the test takers know that you have a limited amount of time. They're not asking you to extrapolate this to outside knowledge or any other situation. A lot of the time when I make a mistake, it's because I overanalyzed the options, I overthought the passage or something along those lines. So don't second guess yourself and just pick the best option that is the most straightforward. Usually the author's topic sentences are the best bet there for getting an idea of what the question wants you to say. And finally, this is something that I touched on, is to make sure to keep track of your timing and to have short-term memory. What this means is if you mess up a question or if you've fumbled a certain difficult passage, do not dwell on it, just forget it, put it out of your memory and focus on the next paragraphs. Don't let it stress you out. The MCAT really tests your mental stamina as well. So just trust your gut and just move on when it is time to move on. That's it for my quick tips for today, guys, and I hope that was helpful, and I wish you all the best in getting that dreams car score.